此使你们今天有人得到，否则将永不能得到。
Chapter 2 Love is the Tao. Ladies and gentlemen, you have received the Tao today, but what did you actually receive? What is the Tao? The Tao is the source of everything. Tao is the creator and master of the universe. Tao is God, the supreme power. Before the earth and sky existed, before the creation of the universe, the Tao existed. After the universe is annihilated and nothing remains, the Tao will continue to exist and to create and control a new universe. The Tao is limitless, invisible and formless. It cannot be seen, heard, smelled or touched and is beyond the power of human comprehension. Tao activates everything. Yet we cannot see its action. It works without effort, yet nothing left undone. Man usually calls it nature. Nothing can exist without the Tao because everything depends on it. Tao is God and our soul issues from God's essence. We are God's children.
第二章蛇魔是道，各位今天已经得到。究竟得的是蛇魔，蛇魔是道，道是天地人万物之母。道是宇宙之本源，创造者立即主宰者。道上帝，道至尊至贵之神。当天地还未生之前，一切都未有之前，道已先存在的。当天地毁灭后，道不毁灭，道能再生天地人万物。天地人万物生成了，道其中主宰。道非常奥妙，道无形无体，是不见听的不闻，不可嗅，不可捉摸。道超出人们的想象力而不思议，亦不可言说，一切皆是道所为。然而我见不到道的动作。道是无为而为的，然一切莫不是道所为。人们常称它为自然。假若无道，任何一物不能存在，因为一切都依靠道而的存。道上帝，我们之灵性是上帝所赐。我们是上帝之儿女，上帝是我们之天。
When we speak of the creator of the universe, we call it Tao. When we speak of the ruler of everything, we call it natural law. When we speak of the animating and controlling principle of our being, we call it soul or conscience.When we speak of the creator of our soul, we refer to the Heavenly Mother. In Chinese, she is called Lao Mu. All I left the above are one and the same.
当我们从它作为宇宙之本源而言，称它为道；在它作为一切之主宰而言，我们称它为理。当它在我们体内，使我们生存并支配肉体时，我们称它为灵性或良心，因为它赋予我们本性。我们称它为老，这些名称虽异而其意相同，皆指同一物而言。
Now.What you have actually received is the Tao. Tao is everybody's true self. Today you have been initiated by the teacher and the door of your mind has been opened. Now you are able to understand that the body is not your true self. The body is killed by the Tao you.
现在你们得的就是道，道是每一个人的真我。今天你们以的名师指点，开了心窍。现在你认识了肉体并非真正的你，而灵性才是真正的你，那位无形无相的。然而在支配你的身体的灵性才是真正的你自己。
While you are alive, your soul dwells within your body. As soon as the soul leaves your body, you are dead. Your soul is from God, but your physical body is from your parents. You already had the Tao within you yet did not realize it. Therefore,You have had to search for it and had now been fortunate enough to find a teacher who was able to transmit it to you. Previously you believed that the physical body was your true self and behaved accordingly. You were selfish, committing misdeeds, acts of violence, and overindulging in physical pleasures.This condition repeatedly led you into a reincarnation and endless sufferings. Now you understand that your true self is not your physical body but only use the body as a vehicle. You are not limited to this physical body. You are boundless. You are the master of the universe because you have God's essence within you.You are full of mercy and love because you share of God's spirit. Most people today have forgotten all these spiritual characteristics and do not know who they really are. Today you are regaining your conscience, your true self.
每个人活时，灵性在他体内，若灵性已离开他立刻就死亡，灵性附于天，而肉体由父母而来。因此，事实上我们已有道在身上，为何还要再寻求他，还要有点传师来传授？原因是我们已不认识他了。我们以为肉体真我而不知它原是假，因此我们变得自私，做了许多错事与罪恶。为了持此色身，享受如此，使我们坠入轮回中，遭受无边痛苦。我们不知真正的我乃是灵性，而我们已不是仅限于此肉身，我们是无限的广大，我们是宇宙之主宰，因我们的灵性与老是一体，我们的本性充满了慈悲与爱心，因我们是老之分灵。然而现在人们都失去了这些品性，亦不知他究竟是谁。今天我们得到是的回真我良心。
Chapter 3 What are the three treasures? Today you have received the three treasures. A. The heavenly portal B. The divine mantra C. The symbolic seal A. The first treasureThe heavenly portal, the point where the teacher placed his finger upon your face during the ceremony, is called the heavenly portal. It is the abode of your true self and can be described in different ways, such as 1. Original nature. This is the true self, soul, or conscience which is eternal and indestructible. 2. The portal of birth and death, the heavenly portal, is the door by which our original nature enters and leaves our body. Confucius asked, "Who can leave the house without using the door? Why do people not follow this way?" 3. The way to heaven. A Buddhist sutra says, "Heaven is 108,000 miles away." These words are the metaphor which actually means that it was not easy to become enlightened because the true teacher was difficult to find and the Tao was not yet widely propagated. Without the proper understanding of the Tao, heaven seems very far away, but with a real understanding of the Tao, heaven is very near. Today your teacher has pointed out the way for you and you may now ascend to and with step.
三章何谓三宝经天你们所得之至宝亦可称为三宝一玄关二口诀三合同一第一宝玄关玄关玄妙莫测之门。玄关点传师向你们指点之处，它有许多名称，一点本性，此是我本来固有的真我灵性良心，它是不毁不灭的，它永远存在。二点生死之门户，玄关是灵性出入身体之门户。孔子曰，谁能出不由户，和莫由斯道也。三点通天大陆，佛经云，西天十万八千里，此是譬喻，亦成佛是不义之事，因为名师难访，大道还未普传。然而名师经已指点明明路，你一步登天。
The main entrance, the heavenly portal, is the main entrance. It is situated at the center and not to the left or right, above or below. This entrance was locked after your imperishable spirit entered the body at birth. If the heavenly portal is not unlocked by your teacher,your true self is not able to leave the body by the main entrance at the time of death. Instead, it will have to leave by one of the side gates, a. the eyes, b. the ears, c. the mouth, d. the nose, e. the navel, f. the vertebrae. If your spirit leaves from the ears, it is reborn as a viviparous animal, such as a horse, pig, cow, sheep, etc. B. eyes, it is reborn as an oviparous bird. C. mouth, it is reborn as a creature of the water, such as a fish, a lobster, etc. D. nose, it is reborn as an insect, such as a fly, a moth, a bee, etc. E. navel, it is reborn as an ordinary person. F. vertex, it is reborn as a wealthy and powerful person. 4.
正门玄关是正门，它正好位于当中，不偏向左也不偏向右，不在上也不在下。当灵性投入身体后，四门关闭了。假如我们不遇名师指开玄关，临终时我们的灵性将无正门可出离身体，它只能由其他旁门出去，眼耳口鼻肚其顶门。如果灵性走旁门，亦由耳而出者，来生当为胎生之动物，如马、猪、牛、羊之类。二由眼而出者，来生当为卵生之动物，如飞鸟之类。三由口而出者，来生当为湿